Alright, 2006, Mazda 3, 5-speed, changing off the clutch. Already got your battery box removed, pretty simple. Air intake box is removed. There's a fuse thing right here that I took out as well, you know. All that's over there, basic stuff. Got some wires that were down here and unremoved. I unhooked them, you know, just run around it. These just pop off. The cables for the shifter. And there's a bracket that was right here. It was attached. I removed that. I really only had a ground on it, so I may just leave that off and put it back. We'll see. This is another bracket I think I'm going to remove. Yeah, so I'm just going to start taking stuff apart. I haven't seen a video about how to do this, so I'm just going to try and document it a little bit. We'll see how it goes. Go ahead and get the CV axle out of the way. What I'm going to use here is a 32 with my Cobalt. That's not an advertisement for you guys, sorry. But it is one of my favorite ones I've had. It's been unstoppable for me, so hopefully we'll see if this will work. Doesn't look like they nicked it down or anything like that, so should just be able to put some Ugga Uggas on it and get it right out. Let's see what happens. Would you look at that? Just look at it. Came out easy. About 14 for that. So far, the only sizes I've used is 14, 17, 32, and 10. So, basic tool setup. Oh wow, that was ridiculously easy. If I can just get a flathead to pop it off, a couple hammer hits. If not, I'll have to go to AutoZone or Riley's or Advance or Napa, whatever you want to choose, to get the tool, the pry bar tool to do it. I'm going to try a flathead. Get screwdrivers first. Yes, I need ball joints, but I don't feel like replacing them because I have to replace the whole damn arm. To replace just that ball joint. Sucks. Let's see. Let me try. I don't want to damage the threads. Let's see what happens. I'm kind of surprised at how. See, that's where you get fucked up. That's still good. Yeah, still good. That's out.
Alright, so this is where I struggled with the CV axle for a little bit. So we're just gonna kind of fast forward through this.
Jesus Christ, that took a lot.
Here we have the exhaust portion of this video. All I'm going to show here is that I unbolted the two bolts that hold the exhaust downpipe to the cat. There's also the two rubber grommets. I also undid a couple of the mounting spots further back on the exhaust just to help with movement to get the bolts, the studs out from the downpipe. But this helped me to tilt the motor in any way I wanted.
Alright, just want to show you guys something. Right over here, we got two transmission bolts. One here, and one's up here. I've already removed them. This one, I'm not able to take out all the way. The top one, I was able to bend the heat shielding back a little bit, put a 10 inch long extension in from the other side of the exhaust over there, reach it through, I was able to break it free, got that one out. I just loosened up the transmission mounting bolts that connect, you know, for the block to transmission. I don't think I'm going to have to do anything with the starter. It looks like that bolted to the block and looks like the cog shoots out, so I don't think there's any connection right now, so I think that'll be okay. I double checked the wiring harness. It looks all good and removed. I'm going to start by supporting it here. I'm going to support down here and take out that bottom motor mount over there. And then I will work on the top motor mount on the transmission side up here. And then after that, I will slowly loosen the engine mount on the other side. And I got a second jack over there to put under the engine just in case, you know, so I can maybe raise it or lower it however I need. Then hopefully should be able to get the transmission out. Probably gonna be shaking the shit out of it and whatnot. I don't think it'll be easy, but it shouldn't be too tough. Kinda got it set up. I got this here just in case. But there's a bolt here, and a nut here, and then a bolt here to remove the motor mount. And here's another bracket for it. These are 17s, and the bracket is 19s. Let's see what I can do. Let's see. That's going to be difficult. Alright, so this side's a 19, this side's a 17. Kinda dumb. got the jacks down here. I'm gonna move that up there. Still unstoppable. That's the bracket. That's my little motor mount. Doesn't look too bad at all. Looks that way. Alright. Wow, look at all that room. Okay, let's get out from under here. So that's what I did. That one and that one. I was able to pull this out. So, I don't know if I explained it at the start of the video. I'm wanting to do a clutch change, which I haven't seen documented, but that's not the real full reason for this recording. I haven't seen it documented. But I'm also trying something where I don't remove anything off the passenger side. My idea is that I will tilt the transmission and engine down, you know, like this, towards the driver's side, using the flashlight example. And, you know, I'll be able to pull things apart right there. It'll all tilt, that all tilts, that's bolted to the block. It should all tilt and bend at this axis, or this axle, sorry. And I should be able to just pop it out with an axle remover and slide everything out, including the transmission. I'm going to loosen this bolt as it looks like it goes into the transmission. I didn't see it before. And it might be, that one's already loose. That one I've already loosened. So I'm going to just loosen this one real quick, probably 14 millimeter. And then I'm going to work on the top side. Transmission mount, and I'm gonna put another jack under here at that point. Alright, guys. So what I'm gonna try and do is I'm gonna see what happens when I remove these four brackets first. I'm thinking it's just a case for the top of this. I'm not really sure, to be honest. So I think those are 17s. Ford. Gotta get this out of the way. Bend those back on whatever. Be able to see if you're thinking this. Just kind of pry the plastic part away from this. So we got two different ways this is mounted. Kind of sucks, but there could be a. I can't tell. Kind of molded all into one, clamped down around here. Really weird design. There's these two bolts here, probably 17. These are two 17s as well. They're probably all, well, these two are directly to the motor block, and those two are to the frame, to the mount. I'm not sure how long those are. I may try to remove one and see. My plan is to leave them in so I can have movement but not have it completely taken out. If that works, great. If it doesn't work, well, shit. This is why I hate this extension. Nothing to hold it on. Every time to turn, right? I'm gonna try it a different way. You wired me awake and hit me with the hand of broken nails. You tied my lead and pulled my chain to watch my blood begin to boil. But I'm gonna break, gonna break my rusty cage and run. I'm gonna break, gonna break my rusty cage and run. Too cold to start a fire, I'm burning diesel, burning dinosaur bones. I'll take the river down to still water and ride a pack of dogs.
I'm also going to
when the forest burns along the road, like God's eyes and my headlights.
I'm not completely taking these out, and this is my method. If you have a different set of tools, you know, and it's like an engine hoist, to hold it up the top. That helps a hell of a lot. And, you know,
undo these brackets completely, tuck it in here or somewhere around here, and you can tilt it a little bit. It's an engine voice, but I don't have mine. It is currently in another state, so I am doing it just janky as well. Not my favorite method of doing it, but
I'm nice right now, man. I feel good. If you have a drink, would you please put it in the air? That party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it. I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke my weed. But my good friends is all I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat. I wanna go to college for the rest of my life. Sit Bankers Club and drink Miller Lite. On Thursday, Thursday, and Tuesday night ice. And I can get pizza, $1 a slice. So fill up my cup, let's get fucked up. I'm next on the table, who want what? I am champion at beer pong. Allen Iverson, Akeem Olajuwon. Don't even bounce, not in my house. Better hope you make it, otherwise you naked. Time isn't wasted when you're getting wasted. Woke up today and all I can say is, that party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it. I wish we taped it. I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke my weed. But my good friends is all I need. Pass out at 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. Man, I love college. Hey, I love drinking. Hey, I love women. Hey, man, I love college. I can't tell you what I learned from school, but I can tell you a story or two. Yeah, of course I learned some rules, like don't pass out with your shoes on, and don't leave the house till the booze gone, and don't have sex if she's too gone. When it comes to condoms, put 2 on, then tomorrow night, find a new joint, hold the beer bong, nothing wrong with some fun, even if you did get a little bit too drunk. Time isn't wasted when you're getting wasted. Woke up today and all I can say is that party last night was awfully crazy. I wish we taped it. I wish we taped it. I danced my ass off and had this one girl completely naked. Drink my beer and smoke my weed. But my good friends is all I need. Pass out 3, wake up at 10, go out to eat, then do it again. If everybody would please put their drink as high as they can. As high as they can, and repeat after me. Chug, 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 chug. Fresh mint, fresh mint, fresh mint, fresh mint. Do something crazy, do something crazy, do something crazy, do something crazy. Keg stand, keg stand.
Graduate, or can I just stay here for the rest of my life?
this old man and me. We're at the bar and we're having us some beers and swapping out on cares. Talking politics, blonde and redhead chicks, old dogs and new tricks and habits we ain't kicked. We talked about God's grace and all the hell we raised. And then I heard the old man say, God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. Said I fought two wars, been married and divorced. What brings you to Ohio? He said, damn if I know. We talked an hour or two about every girl we knew, what all we put them through, like two old boys will do. We pondered life and death. He lit a cigarette, said these damn things will kill me, yeah. But God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. Last call is 2 a.m., I said goodbye to him. I never talked to him again. Then one sunny day, I saw the old man's face, front page obituary. He was a millionaire. He left his fortune to some guy he barely knew. His kids were mad as hell, but me, I'm doing well. And I drop by the day, just say thanks and pray. And I left a six pack right there on his grave. And I said, God is great, beer is good, and people are crazy. God is great, beer is good,
this one here. Found it.
Alright, this guy's being a little sneaky bastard. This ball right here, that's holding it all in. And that's how you remove a transmission. Yeah. So I wasn't excited. I wanted to get the flywheel off, or the clutch plate off before I went to eat. I got it set up like this. It's not my favorite work, but it's what I did. I'm sure y'all can come up with something else. I was hoping to have something stick in and poke right up at it, you know, keep it from rotating. I just couldn't think of anything right off the bat here to do that, so this is what I went with. And I'm just gonna, I've got them kind of loosened up already. Got the flywheels out. That's the old one. That's the new one. It is a little bit different, but for the most part it all seems to match and everything. I'm gonna bolt it up and see. The way I got this one off was just my impact gun. That guy right there, you can kind of see. It didn't rotate the engine or anything like that. I'm gonna have to find a way to hold it still while I torque that one back on. Alright, hey bud. So I went to my local hardware store, aka AutoZone, for the pilot bearing puller. Part number is 8070. This one should work for this car. I tested it on the new pilot bearing. This seems to fit in. And then you tighten it down and it should just pull right on out. Alright, so real quick here, I just want to show you what I was going from with the old stuff and to the new stuff. This is the old one, the old throwout bearing. You can hear that, that's pretty bad. Looks well rusted and well worn. And I honestly, I'm not sure that it was replaced last time, because when I looked at this friction plate here, it don't look too terrible. Like, it's got a good bit of life left on it, to be honest. You can tell. It just looks like, you know, each of these spots, you know, you can tell the grooves here. They're not worn flat. It's not flush. You know, this doesn't look too bad to me. I mean, look at the new one. Here, I'll take it out of the package real quick. Besides it being a little bit cleaner, see how it doesn't look as worn? Or, I mean, obviously this one's not worn, but you know what I mean. The other one looks pretty good, considering it's got all these grooves and, you know, it's not worn flush to the rivet parts yet. Like, I think that this clutch was done recently, Not everything got replaced, such as the pilot bearing, throwout bearing. And look at this. Looks like it was never even touching there, but it was rubbing all there. All around, on the outside, very outside. This very inside edge isn't even, I know that you may not use all of it, but still, if it was done right, it's gonna rub smoothly and evenly when it's pressed. Should cover most of that, and it's not. So that tells me that something wasn't torqued right, or it was warped, or I was assuming that the flywheel was warped, and I don't know. It had a couple of those wear spots on it, but that's why it's important to torque your stuff down evenly. Even if you don't torque it, you get it good and tight, but it's all even. You have a torque wrench. If you don't know the torques, torque it evenly. Of course, these parts, you really do want to know the torques and get it torqued correctly. You don't want to just torque it for 10 foot-pounds and call it good. You need to go up quite a bit. But that's the new one. See how I gotta clean off the old oils with the new brake pad. It looks pretty good. So, new throw bearings going in, new pilot bearing, new pressure plate, new friction disc, and I think it'll be good. I think that someone did a rush job last time, and that's what's causing me to do this so soon, because like I said, this friction plate don't look bad. This looks like shit. However it's supposed to go, throws it out from the other side, actually. Anyways. I'm going to look up the torques real quick for this pressure plate, and I'll be right back to you guys will be no time. Pounds, which is 228 inch pounds.